Malaria is a deadly disease. Every year, an estimated 584,000 people die from it. And around the world, 1.2 billion people are at high risk of contracting it. 90% of deaths are in sub-Saharan Africa. And in 2012, malaria killed nearly 500,000 children before their fifth birthday. That's about one child dying every minute. Malaria creates an unhealthy working population and is responsible for an estimated economic loss of $12 billion each year in Africa alone. Despite massive investments, current combined efforts have not been enough to make sure that we live in a world free of malaria. As a global not-for-profit alliance of researchers, Target Malaria wants to help save millions of lives from this killer. We wondered whether we could do something different, something to stop malaria in its tracks. The solution? Target the source. Malaria is a human disease caused by the parasite Plasmodium. But it is female mosquitoes that spread the disease between people when they bite us to feed. Although worldwide there are over 3,500 species of mosquito, most of them don't transmit malaria. In Africa, the majority of malaria cases are actually caused by a cluster of three closely related species, all in the genus Anopheles. So, if we could reduce the population of these mosquitoes, that would mean there would be fewer of them around to spread the disease. So how can we do this? At Target Malaria, we are initially focusing our research on how to reduce, specifically, the numbers of the most deadly of the malaria-transmitting mosquitoes in Africa, Anopheles gambiae. To do this, we are investigating enzymes that can target specific sequences of mosquito DNA. Our researchers are inserting genes into mosquitoes' eggs, which code for these special enzymes. We are testing to see if they can be activated at just the right moment to affect their reproductive ability. For example, we are using the enzyme to cut the DNA of the X chromosome while males are making their sperm. This means that almost no functioning sperm carry the female X chromosome, and as a result, mostly male offspring will be produced. We are also exploring using the enzyme to disrupt the fertility of female mosquitoes, so they have fewer offspring. In all of these approaches, the modified mosquitoes can pass these genes on to their offspring, meaning the modification is spread throughout the specific population relatively quickly and is effectively self-sustaining. This makes the reduction of the mosquito vector population relatively low cost and simple, because the mosquitoes themselves do the work. But the research takes time, and we are still in an early phase of the project. Researchers in our laboratories in England and Italy are currently testing these different methods on mosquitoes to understand which will work best. At the same time, we are gathering information on mosquito behaviour with our medical entomologists in Africa. We work step by step, learning and refining our approach along the way, and ensuring that human well-being and environmental considerations are fundamental to all. We engage actively with our stakeholders to share our progress and build support for our work. Our teams also work with local communities, regulatory agencies, and government officials so that we understand their hopes and take their concerns into account. No part of the project goes ahead without this consent. The technologies we are developing are complementary to other malaria control methods, such as bed nets, vaccines, and anti-malarial drugs. And all of our researchers have pledged that our technology will be available to developing countries at no or low cost. A child dying every minute from malaria has to stop. At Target Malaria, we believe that our technology could be part of the solution to create a malaria-free world. Learn about our work and follow our progress at www.targetmalaria.org.